I'm a second year music student at Leeds University, and I'm a singer-songwriter and performer, and I have been, well, it's kind of childhood dream, I suppose, that I'm going to do my best to make into a career. I do a lot of gigging around, lots of singing for different bands and stuff, which is quite fun. Recently got into the kind of the jazz scene, which is quite fun. But yeah, I write sort of lots of different genres, trying to find a key one, but it's going to be tricky. I think I've got lots of different influences. I'm swinging more towards a fusion of kind of jazz, pop, sort of ballads in that way. But I want to kind of branch out into a bit of kind of more blues and reggae and sort of funk sort of stuff as well, because I sing for a funk soul cover band, and that's having an effect on the way I sing and stuff. So it would definitely be really good to start writing in that genre as well. I have to go straight in there with Alicia Keys, as generic as it is as a pianist, singer, songwriter, but she's just phenomenal. The way she's done so many different albums of kind of different styles has been great. Alicia Keys, yeah, definitely. Joss Stone, Norah Jones, and Eva Cassidy are my four top, I'd say.
It's been a long, long, a long, long 2 years.
It's hard for a writer to sort of say the specifics, to sort of tell someone the specifics behind a song, because I guess the whole point of writing is to write for other people to kind of feel a link with that song. So I'll write about a certain experience that I've had, but I won't necessarily be performing it as this is what's happened to me. I'll perform it in a kind of way so other people can say, oh yeah, that sounds like something that's happened to me, or I can relate to that sort of thing. I draw from lots of different things. Obviously love is a big one, but you know, anything that I try and find muse from, I try and make it as universal as possible so it can basically be related to by as many people as possible, really. Sometimes I'll get a melody hook in my head, and I'll go to the piano and work out chords for it. Often it's the music that comes first, and lyrics come after I've decided on what I want to write about. So sometimes there'll be a certain topic that I'll want to write about, so I'll sit down with that in mind and then just see what comes. But it's not a kind of strict step-by-step process. They know they can't have. We know each other from home, which is really handy that he's now in Leeds as well. Yeah, so we did a lot at home and at our old school. We did kind of assemblies and band stuff like that. Pubs around us. And we're going to try and do more in Leeds. It's been tricky because obviously we're both at different unis and stuff, and it's not as easy as it sounds really to do as many gigs with each other. Kind of got different schedules and stuff. But yeah, we do recordings and duo stuff, got some YouTube stuff as well, so as much as possible. I'm currently looking at going to record with a couple of different producers. One of them's a third year Leeds College of Music. Well, he's now going to be a graduate. And he's got a really different style, a different sound, which would really help in kind of defining or even taking me in a completely different direction. Normally just solo voice and solo piano, and lots of kind of open mic nights and clubs kind of they enjoy that sort of stuff. But once you've done quite a few of those nights, it's hard to kind of get into the bigger sound and the bigger scene, because you really need a band behind you. So I think the main aim for me is going to be finding a sound, getting a band together, and then going out and doing some of the bigger places to gig. Some people will be, you know, really go-getting and going to every gig and doing every single possible thing they can do. And that's exactly what I used to be like in first year. I came to a new city and I was like, right, I'm going to go to all these places. I'm going to tell them that I'm a musician. I'm going to basically shove my music in as many people's faces as possible and see how many gigs and stuff I could get out of that. And that worked well for the first few months, I think. Getting your name out there is definitely a really key stage to cross first. But then you can start thinking about the places you want to play, the people you want to play to. Sometimes it's not worth getting all your equipment down to one gig if you're going to be playing to three people that have heard your set before or something like that. So it's definitely about prioritising. And that's taken a while to sort of realise, because I think I was just very much doing everything. Every exposure is great.
They can't have the one thing they know they can't have.
I'm on YouTube and SoundCloud and Facebook, general internet. if you go to Facebook and type in Phoebe Katis Music, that will come to my Facebook page, and then it's got lots of links and things on there.
Trying to find another heart that's one of a kind. Different stories with different lines, but it's taken me a long, long time. Baby, I've been trying to tell whether I have to find another fella. But every time I try to turn the page, no matter what, I won't see your face. Well, baby, life has turned us separate ways. So how can this transition be so hard to make? I need to get over you, baby. I need somebody new, honey. It kills me every time I hear you say, maybe it's better if we stay this way. Time to realize I